Hey guys, I'm Kent and you're watching DiaGraphics. Today I want to show you how to delete objects from a photo and go from something like this to this inside Adobe Photoshop. So I want to show you two different ways of removing objects in Photoshop. The manual way and a more quicker way. So first you want to go to the background and drag it down to new layer to make a copy of it. This way you're working on the copy instead of the original. Then you want to zoom in on the object you want to remove. Then go to the clone stamp tool over here. Then you want to find a spot that would look like the spot behind the car. So this spot will do the job. Now you want to hold down the Alt key or the Option key if you're on Mac until you get this cross. This is where you want to sample from. A nice place to begin is with the horizontal line right here. So you sample the horizontal line. And you go over here and make it match, make the horizontal line match, and then you just start drawing like this. Then release the mouse and click again and keep doing this. And you can see the horizontal line is not exactly clean right now, so do it again and make it more clean right here. As you can see, you are copying this little green bush right here. And that looks fake because it's a pattern. So you can always just resample another spot and delete those. Now keep going, sample this spot and keep drawing on the car. Go here, delete the green bush, sample and draw, sample and draw. And it doesn't have to be perfect right away. You just need to remove the car. You can smooth out this spot a little bit if you just sample here and just keep drawing, sampling different places to make it more natural. We want some of this grass and earth texture. And obviously you can do this a lot better if you have a lot of time, but for the sake of this video, this will be okay. And you can see, no one will ever know there was a car there. So now for the main. This is a little bit harder because the background is more uneven, as you can see. So zoom in on the main. You want to go to the clone stamp tool again and start with the horizontal line again. You can make the brush a little bit bigger for this one. So you can hold down the Alt key and right click and hold the right click button and you can just drag it and make it bigger. Or you can do it up here. So resample the horizontal line right here. And just draw like this. Sample again and click a few times to correct some of these mistakes. I'll make the brush a little bit smaller again and go in and correct some of these duplicates right here. Make the brush a little bit bigger again, sample here and draw over the main. And I am sampling different spots again to make it look more natural. Now go for the sand and just keep drawing right here. Sample different spots again to make it look more natural. And you can see this looks a little bit weird. So make the brush a little bit smaller to give it more texture. And I will just delete this. I think that looks quite natural. Go down here, make the brush a little bit bigger, and you can see it's kind of like the same bush all the way. So you can just sample from here and go here and just click and draw. And you can kind of like draw your own bushes right here. And you see this pattern right here. Delete that so it looks more natural. Make the brush a little bit smaller, where it's detailed. Go for the horizontal line, right here, sample the horizontal line, and draw. And as you can see, this is a duplicated pattern. So then again, go mix it up and make it a little more unpredictable. Then for the sand, it's quick and easy. Just duplicate the sand. Delete the legs right here. And then copy the bush to make it look more natural. Like this. And copy the bush here. And make it look more natural up here. Copy the bush, draw down the legs right here. Go down. And this is a duplicate too, you can see. So I will draw over it again. And for the shadow, we want to remove that. We want to sample a spot and draw. And as I said before, you can obviously do this a lot better if you have a lot of time. But for the sake of this video, this will be fine. And as you can see, when I zoom out, no one will ever know there was a person or a car right here. That was the manual way, so now I want to show you a more quick way. So let's delete what we just did. Then we want to take the background and make a copy of it, so we are working on the copy and not the original. Now zoom in again. And this time we want to use the lasso tool. Then draw around the thing you want to remove as close as possible without touching. So go like this. Really close. Now you want to right click and select fill. And you want to use content aware and click OK. Then click Control or Command and D. And you can see sometimes you're lucky or sometimes you're really unlucky, but this time it looks quite realistic. But there are still some flaws, so take the stamp tool and then just sample a spot and draw here. You just want to clean it a little bit up and make it look more natural. That's fine. Now for the person. This is a little bit harder because it's not an even background. But you can still use the same technique. So go for the lasso tool. Draw around the person. And just make it as close as possible. And I'll choose his shadow too. Then right click and select fill. Use content aware and select OK. Then you want to click Control or Command and D again to deselect the selection. And as you can see, this is not nearly as well done as the one before, but it still did a lot of the job. So now we just need to go down and clean it up. So zoom in, select the stamp tool again. Then you want to sample the horizontal line and go over here and just draw this in like this. Then go down here and sample this and clean it up a little bit. That looks fine. This obviously looks really unnatural, so here we definitely need to clean it up a little bit. Sample the sand and just draw over it. And here's the bushes, so we want to sample the bush and just draw here. And I'm drawing my own bushes right here. Just keep going. Make sure there's no duplicates next to each other. This spot looks a little unnatural too, so select some bush, some grass, and clean it up like this. That looks nice. For the sand, do the same thing. This line right here is really unnatural, so just copy it a little bit. And you can see you can do this better, but for the sake of this video, I'll make it quick. This is a little unnatural, so let's just fix this quick. You can make the brush a little bit smaller to make a sharper line, or you can choose to give the brush a little more hardness. This will make a sharper line too. So as you can see, no one will ever notice there was a person or a car right here. And this is basically how you remove an object from a photo inside Adobe Photoshop. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of these graphic design tutorials. Thank you for watching.